In part A, we will purify a sample of sulfanilamide by performing a recrystallization. Measure and record the mass of the sample that is going to be recrystallized. Transfer the sample to an Erlenmeyer flask. Then add several boiling stones. The boiling stones provide nucleation sites where bubbles can form. This prevents the boiling from becoming overly vigorous. Add a small amount of the recrystallization solvent to the flask containing the sample. There should be enough liquid added to cover the solid that is present. Fill a second Erlenmeyer flask with additional solvent to be heated and used during the recrystallization. A boiling chip should be added to the second flask as well. Turn on the hot plate. Be sure to choose a temperature that is well above the boiling point of the recrystallization solvent. Wait for the solvent to approach its boiling point. Slowly add boiling hot solvent until the sample fully dissolves. Once the sample is fully dissolved, remove the Erlenmeyer flask from the hot plate and allow the mixture to cool to room temperature. The mixture is then further cooled in an ice bath, and over time, crystals form. The crystals will be separated from the supernatant by vacuum filtration. Firmly clamp the filter flask. Attach a vacuum hose to the sidearm of the filter flask. Place a Hirsch funnel on top of the filter flask. A small piece of filter paper is placed inside the Hirsch funnel. A trap between the filter flask and the vacuum source prevents liquids from accidentally being sucked into the vacuum source. Turn on the vacuum. Wet the filter paper with solvent. Swirl the flask to disperse the crystals throughout the suspension, then quickly pour the suspension into the Hirsch funnel. Use ice-cold solvent to rinse the remaining crystals into the Hirsch funnel. Record the mass of a watch glass that will be used to weigh the crystals. When the crystals are dry, they are ready to collect. Turn off the vacuum. Transfer the crystals to the watch glass and remove the boiling chips. Record the mass. Prepare a melting point capillary to measure the melting point of the recrystallized material. Prepare a melting point capillary of the impure material for comparison. Record the melting points. The sample on the left is the impure material, and the sample on the right is the material from after the recrystallization.